the mainstream news media. While Americans rely on it daily for the latest reports on world and domestic events, a recent study conducted by the Cronkite School of Journalism indicates that nearly 67% of Americans don't trust major media for accurate reporting. Ask Americans specifically why they distrust the media, and the answers are generally vague. After all, reports of news media abuses aren't normally found on the front page or the nightly news. Nonetheless, they do exist.
Americans' opinion of Senator Hillary Clinton continues to get more negative.
This tape shows Hillary Clinton in the process of committing at least 4 or 5 felonies under federal election law.
Hillary and Bill Clinton suffer from ADD.
Hillary Sodom Clinton, the front-running Democrat presidential nomination for 2008, next year, is a Jew hater.
Stop arguing. I think she's out to get the women vote because she has a right to it because she's a woman, and you go for your people first.
Hi, everybody. Tonight's big story, the gloves are off. Hillary Clinton reported to be already digging up the dirt on Barack Obama.
I think I agree that Hillary has been very hawkish on the war, far more hawkish than I, an out-of-the-closet right-winger, has been.
Than Hillary, that she harkens back to the 90s. I think she's been a very sensible senator. I think, in fact, it's hard to disagree with her on the war. But when I see her again, all the cootie vibes sort of resurrect themselves.
That's a technical term.
I'm sorry, I must represent
we
a lot of people.
Politics, yeah.
I actually find her positions appealing in many ways. I just can't stand her.
Take a look at what she really said when she cast that vote and what she's saying now.
Welcome back to Harbaugh. Hillary Clinton seems to have a strategy. Nobody gets to criticize her.
Senator Hillary Clinton became a New Yorker specifically to run for the Senate. Now some wonder if she's trying to become a Southerner to run for president after a rather strange speech in Selma, Alabama. Take a listen.
Does Hillary Clinton support universal health care, that is health care for all Americans paid for by the government?
Man, I don't know about you, but I don't think anybody saw this one coming. Hillary Clinton has decided to run for president. I heard that. I had to read it three or four times. As I watched Hillary's announcement on her website, which I watch all the time, it's great, I was struck by a couple of things. One, her delivery. It had all the charm and charisma of a roof shingle.
Welcome back to Hannity and Combs. The vast right-wing conspiracies dossier on Hillary Clinton is a new book that claims New York Senator and presidential hopeful Hillary Clinton has been stuffing her war chest full of foreign dollars.
Everybody lies in politics, but they, the Clintons, they do it with such ease it's troubling. Bill was a reckless guy. God knows, is there anyone more politically ambitious than Hillary?
Senator Hillary Clinton hits the Hawkeye State campaigning and singing, and further nuancing her stand on Iraq with the implication we need to be out of there or on the way out of there before Mr. Bush is on his way out of the White House. Making her first visit as a presidential candidate to the first stop on the campaign trail over the weekend, choosing a town hall question and answer session to step up her rhetoric against the administration.
Apparently March 1st is the time when Newt's going to break out the claws because he now is calling her a nasty woman.
Endlessly ruthless campaigner, does think she'll be the nominee, but says no one will out-mud the Clintons.
Some interesting correlations being made today about the French presidential election and the U.S. election coming up next year. Carol Costello once again joining us from New York. What's this all about, Carol?
Well, Wolf, it's about riding on a winner's coattails and using that other guy's win to deflect criticism from yourself.
The middle class, what do they want?
They want whatever's not Hillary. Gary B is dead on, and really, Rudy is better just because he's not Hillary. This health care is exactly what Gary B was talking about. It is universal health care. It's going to kill the middle class. You look at what the Democrats have done.
Seriously, would it be good for America to have Bill Clinton back living in the White House?
You've got to be kidding.
No, I'm not. His wife's running.
The only thing I can think of to be as bad as that would be to have the gang of three running the war on terror: Pelosi, Reid, and Hillary Clinton. So I have to be honest with you. I think it'd be awful thing.
No, because it obviously would mean that Senator Clinton is the President of the United States, and we don't want that.
Well, should the Clintons come back to the White House, especially?
No one on this stage probably knows Hillary Clinton better than I do, and I will tell you that it's probably not a good idea either of them.
Congressman Bill Clinton.
Senator Clinton's recent positions, and the reality is in the 1990s, we were on defense in dealing with Islamic fundamentalist terrorism.
Senator Brownback,
for a lot of reasons.
I think it'd be bad because it would mean that Hillary Clinton would be elected, not because of who she is, but because of the policies that she stands for.
No, because that would mean that Hillary Clinton would be President of the United States, and where you have been is where you're going to go. And Hillary Clinton tried to socialize medicine in this, a very bad idea. You need to keep that in the private sector.
Were you surprised yesterday when Hillary Clinton in New Hampshire raised the specter of a grand right-wing conspiracy? Raised the specter of a grand right-wing conspiracy. A grand right-wing conspiracy.
Conversation. November
2008. But we have to change the way we finance health care. And that's going to mean taking money away from people who make out really well right now. So this is going to be a big political battle.
To set a goal of universal, quality, affordable health care for every single man, woman, and child.